Oh, that's a beautiful book. But you have to understand the New Covenant. Otherwise, it's just long sentences with many commas and colons and semicolons. Hard to understand. But when you see what Jesus did, the book of Hebrews opens up. So we need to see, we respect the people that are praying at the Wailing Wall. We'll see them tomorrow. We respect their faith. We respect all people. That goes without saying. And I wouldn't speak, even if I was speaking to an audience of non-Christians, I would choose my words much more carefully than I am right now. Mika understands, and so I'm just not, you know, because we are respectful of all people. It says about the great apostle Paul, when he was in Ephesus, what does it say in Acts 19? That they said of Paul, he does not speak against our goddess Diana. So when Paul came to Ephesus, he didn't preach against Diana. He didn't say, oh, Diana is no good. We have had modern-day American preachers who have gone to Ephesus to rebuke Diana, but not Paul. He wasn't busy condemning other religions. He preached Jesus. He preached what Jesus has done. And I'm telling you, but I want you to see what the Wailing Wall is. I want you to see religion. See religion. Mm-hmm. Trying to get closer to God. The closer we can get, the better it is. Because God is still located in a certain geographical spot. That's religion. Whether it's in Mecca or in Jerusalem, that's religion. God is in a holy piece of real estate. So don't get caught up in that. You have to get you saved all over again on the flight home. You can speak in tongues, you can pray in English, you can do whatever thing you want. You can do it here, on the bus, or at the Wailing Wall. You can do all the prayers you want. I'm saying your prayers are not more effective there. Because your prayers are effective because Jesus Christ conquered death. He conquered all the obstacles, and the veil has been rent. Praise God, and God moved out. He's been out ever since. What's he doing now? He's moving among people. Why? Because the sins have already been punished. You see, God has more people problem with sin than we do. We don't have a lot of problem with sin, really. Remember when the Israelites came out of Egypt? Did they put the blood on the outside of the doorpost or on the inside? On the outside. Why? So God could see. The people didn't say, we're so bad we put some blood on the inside. No, the people thought, they were good enough. In the Garden of Eden, did Adam volunteer? Did he say, God, please kick me out, I've been so bad? No, God had more problem with sin than Adam did. God always had more problem with sin. But God has solved the problem with sin. How did he solve it? He poured all the anger of sin on Jesus. Oh, praise God. So don't get too, you respect the people, but understand what Jesus has done. Hallelujah. Amen.